This is the Elegoo Centauri Carbon. It's one of the most talked about 3D printers right now, and I've been testing it on and off for the past couple of weeks, and it really proves the point that 3D printers are getting ridiculously cheap, and cheap 3D printers are getting ridiculously good. Recently, I took a look at the FlashForge A5M Pro, a similar fully enclosed CoreXY type machine, and for the price, it was a fine, decent machine, but it had obvious drawbacks like a dim, unresponsive screen, cheapish feeling parts, and I guess it just wasn't the same level of polish as the more expensive 3D printers that I'm used to. But I said that was fine, it's a really cheap machine after all, so they have to cost cut somewhere, right? Well, maybe not. The Centauri Carbon, on the other hand, is polished, it's responsive, it produces high quality prints, and it's probably the best bang for your buck machine on the market right now. So, what's the catch? But first, let's start from the beginning with the setup process. It includes tools, sample filament, a glue stick, USB drive, power cable, touchscreen, and spool holder, you know, all the stuff you'd expect. And after screwing in the spool holder, placing the lid on top, unscrewing the build platform, and attaching the screen, it was ready to boot up. After connecting it to Wi-Fi, I let it run through the auto calibration and wow, it is incredibly loud. But don't worry, for me, it was only this obnoxious during calibration and not during the actual printing, thank goodness. Anyway, I loaded in some filament for my first print and I have to say the screen is responsive, it's bright and it's really premium feeling, and I'd say it's on par with the Bambu Lab X1C, but I'll talk more about that later. Because while loading the filament, I noticed this huge bulge in the side panel. I'm not sure if this is due to shipping damage or came out of the factory like this. It shouldn't affect performance, but I'm just a bit concerned it could be a sign of other larger issues perhaps. But anyway, what you've been waiting for, let's do some prints. Alrighty, here's the first batch of prints, and first up is my Maker Coin. It printed well, the detail all looks good. My only complaint is the top surface layer, which is a bit rougher than what I would expect. It could be an issue with the filament, but either way, it's nothing that some simple troubleshooting shouldn't be able to fix. So I changed filament, and then I followed it up with a Benchy, which is now completely open source by the way, and it came out just about flawlessly. There is a tiny amount of stringing, but who cares, this is a great quality print. I also printed a botched Benchy. Don't worry, it's meant to look like this. This is actually from a shot I uploaded a week or so ago where I 3D scanned Benchy, then 3D printed that scan, 3D scanned the new Benchy, and so on 10 times until it slowly devolved into this. Just as a fun little experiment, I guess. And again, there are no issues with this print. So after we take a look at some specs, let's do some larger and much more difficult prints. But first, can you tell me what this metal 3D printed part, this aluminium CNC'd wallet, this chrome plated CNC'd badge, and this amazing clear resin 3D printed phone case all have in common? Well, the answer is that these are just some of the things that PCBWay have manufactured for me. They have a huge range of manufacturing capabilities, and you just need to upload your 3D model, select what material and surface finish you want, then they do all the hard manufacturing work and ship it out to you when it's done. PCBWay are my go-to for parts that I just can't make by myself. And if you want to save $5 on your first order, please check out the link below. Cheers. Okay, let's talk pricing and specs. The Centauri Carbon is 650 Australian dollars, but if you want to save a bit, you can instead opt for the base model Centauri for $500, which removes the enclosure, hardened steel nozzle for printing with fancy carbon or glass reinforced filament, as well as the camera and some fans. However, they're otherwise identical with the same 256mm³ print volume and the same nice touchscreen display. And if we compare this against Bambu Lab's similar 3D printers, the P1S and P1P, you can see that you're actually getting a bit more for a bit less with Elegoo's 3D printers. I haven't included print speed because that can be a bit misleading sometimes, but these are all basically 500mm a second. The main difference here is multicolor support. Bambu Lab printers are compatible with their AMS, allowing for up to 16 color printing. With Elegoo though, they've announced that they're working on a similar solution for their Centauri for release in Q3 this year, but no other details have been confirmed to my knowledge. We can also compare these printers to my previous budget pick, the FlashForge A5M series, which starts $50 cheaper, but has a smaller print volume and no official multicolor printing support. But now that the Centauri is here, the A5M Pro in particular is in such a weird spot that I'd say it's just no longer a good deal unless you can find it with a good discount. And just for fun, let's compare it to the premium Bambu Lab X1C. Assuming that Elegoo's multicolor solution eventually releases, these printers are very similar, except in price. Specs are only one part of the equation though, so let's hit this thing with some more rigorous testing and see how it performs. And for that, I'm going to print my newly released model, the Minidoo. It's a remix of my Modgeridoo design, it's just smaller with a different sound, and it's a single piece rather than a modular instrument. Unfortunately, the first layer seems to have struggled here, and thinking back, I'm not actually sure if I auto-leveled the bed, so I just started it again, making sure I did, and there were no issues this time around. And here it is. I used a gradient filament for this, which came out looking really nice. Plus, I also designed and printed a multi-part version that screws together, just in case you want to print it on a smaller 3D printer. If you watched my previous video, you'd know that I had some bad experiences with a certain 3D printer from a certain different manufacturer, which caused some prints to be 99% fine, but the other 1% to be so bad that it ruined the whole print. Like this extra large Pikmin vase I made, which has some really bad overhangs, and also this. So I'm going to retry this print on the Centauri Carbon and see what happens. And here it is. It's a bit smaller, but it printed just about perfectly. Another print that I had fail on that same different 3D printer was an airless basketball, which can be a bit tricky to print since they use flexible filament, so I thought that would be another good test, but unfortunately I didn't have enough filament for another full basketball, but this airless tennis ball came out really well. The underside where the supports connected is a bit rough, but I'm not actually sure if this can be improved when printing with flexible materials, but if I'm wrong, please let me know down below. I also printed the included file for a scraper. The blades and screws were already included in the box, so I just had to print the parts and put it all together. And here are all the things I've printed so far, but there's one more test that I need to do, and that's to print with nylon carbon fiber filament, which can be a bit tricky since it's abrasive, and it needs to be thoroughly dried out before use. So I chucked it into my filament dryer on max blast for 5 hours, loaded it into the printer, and almost immediately started having issues. It seems like there could still be a bit of moisture in the filament, so I put it back into the filament dryer overnight, and instead of using the included build plate, I'm instead going to try my smooth engineering plate with a tiny bit of glue. This build plate is meant for Bambu Lab machines, but it mostly fits, so let's see if it actually works. And here they are, two parts made with PACF, with 50% infill and 3 wall layers. So hopefully this thing is going to hold up a lot better over time compared to something like PLA. Okay, so now that I've run through some tests, what are my thoughts? Well, starting with the obvious, this is the best budget CoreXY machine on the market right now. In fact, it's barely a competition. But it still does come with some potential downsides, like I'm unsure how repairable this machine is, or if a wide selection of replacement parts are going to become available. Right now, you can basically only buy nozzles and heat beds. There isn't an app available, but maybe you'll consider that a good thing. There is, however, a local web interface. The camera isn't amazing quality, and the LED light may as well not be there given how dim it is, but I can excuse both of those for the price. The big one is the lack of multicolor support at launch. It's a bit odd, and again they've announced an add-on for later this year, but if you absolutely need multicolor, I would recommend waiting until it becomes available rather than buying the printer now with only the promise of an add-on later on in the future. And finally, there's the whole sci-fi design vibe going on, which I honestly didn't think I was going to like, but it's grown on me and it differentiates itself from every other identical looking machine on the market, but maybe it's not for everyone. So yeah, besides those things, as well as a few easily fixable issues like the build plate adhesion and minor print quality issues, I didn't really run into any major issues with this machine. Not to say that there aren't any, I just haven't run into any of them. But the thing that really gets me with the Centauri Carbon is how absolutely wild it is. It's as expensive as the A1, but seems to compete more with the X1C. It's cheaper than the A5M Pro, but it's better in every single way. It honestly makes half the 3D printers on the market right now look like plain bad deals. how they got this thing so cheap while also being so good genuinely shocks me. But anyway, I know I'm going to keep using this machine and you'll probably see it in a few shots here and there. So please let me know if you have any questions about it. Cheers.